Through the last few decades, ICT has changed the social, political, and economic landscape of the world. Being a part of our lives, with the integration of telecommunications, computers, software, and storage systems, which enable users to create, access, store, transmit, and manipulate information. From the moment we wake up, to the moment we sleep, ICT is permeating our daily lives. As individuals wanting progress, ICT is vital in our country's nation building. To ensure that we do so, we should have a department focused on developing and implementing policies and the exposure regulations and infrastructure needed to cultivate and enrich the country's ICT environment. Thus, the Department of Information and Communication Technology Act of 2015, or Republic Act 10844, was passed. The ICT law abolishes the ICT office, the National Computer Institute, the Telecommunications Office, the National Computer Center, and all communication-related units operating in the DOAC, which most people don't know have not been there for very, very long. Moreover, through the RDA, the Department of Transportation and Communication will likely be renamed to the Department of Transportation, and the National Telecommunications Commission, the Cybercrime Investigation and Coordination Center, and the National Privacy Commission will be attached agencies of the Department of ICT. The law also created a Council of CIOs, which will assist the Department implementing the ICT initiatives. The law defines CIOs as senior officials in all national government agencies, including constitutional offices, state universities, colleges, government-owned and controlled corporations, and government financial institutions. It also provides that the department may create sectoral and industry task forces, technical working groups, advisory bodies, or committees. To understand the ICT further, we should explicate its powers and functions. Powers and functions are classified into four parts, namely policy and planning, improved public access, resource sharing and capacity building, and consumer protection and industry development. The ICT is tasked to articulate and implement national policies, plans, and programs, and shall be responsible for providing an integrated framework to optimize state ICT networks and resources. As such, it is the department's responsibility to create and develop the national ICT agenda, which includes the update of the National ICT Development Plan for 2017-2022. This also includes further developments for the e-government master plan and the national cybersecurity master plan. Collectively, the national ICT agenda aims to provide strategic, reliable, cost-efficient, citizen-centered information and communication technology infrastructure, systems and resources as instruments for good governance and global competitiveness. To respond to the responsibility to establish a few free internet services that can access to public areas and government offices using the most cost-effective technology, the DIC is bound to continue its national connectivity program that aims to provide free internet connectivity across the country and promote digital inclusion through one domain, free Wi-Fi access and public gracious project, and technologies and initiative. One of them recently launched sites in Batangas, Carlac, Bahamas Island. On the other hand, the UI Space Initiative received the PhD Impact Award given by Concordia, the US State Department of State Secretary's Office of Global Partnerships and the University of Virginia. The e-government master plan aims to innovate work processes and be able to deliver better public services. The key and the iGovernment project aim improve the efficiency of internal operations of government agencies. On the topic of consumer protection and industry development, the DICT's responsibilities are to ensure and protect the rights and welfare of consumers and business users, privacy, security, and confidentiality in matters relating to ICT. In coordination with agencies concerned, the private sector, and relevant international bodies. As a response to this, the cybersecurity program aims to ensure that the World Wide Web is safe for individuals, businesses, and the government through collaboration with private, public, and international partners. Recently, the ICT office has conducted cybersecurity emergency response team workshop to respond to the challenges and needs of the ever-growing cyber skills. We have been promoting strategic partnerships and alliances between and among the international ICT institutions. Since the inception of the ICT office, with the birth of the DIC, we shall continue to fulfill the function of speeding up industry growth and enhancing competitiveness, mobility workers, firms, and small and medium enterprises in the global markets of ICT and ICT-enabled services. Specifically, we have done this through projects named Rural Impact Sourcing, Mentoring Cities, and setting up the value. It is also fulfilled in the grassroots by the Tech4Ed project, which recently won the World Summit on Information Society 2016 award under the E-Employment Action Plan. It is noteworthy to mention that not all our programs and projects, the ICTO, are aligned to the agenda of the government. As mentioned at the beginning of the presentation, ICT permeates our everyday lives, and it is easy to see where it can support government. As support for farmers and other agricultural workers to gain wider market access and improve productivity, the One Connect BYY project, or M4 BYY Space Initiative, can be a starting point for improvement of the lives of farmers, regular workers, other fields, as well as the free internet access and the training that comes along with it. Case in point, the fishermen in Adobo who participated in Inquirer's fisher folk registration system received 2 million pesos worth of funding and at the same time was given the PT Impact Award by the board. Moreover, the IDOC Bill project has government services online for easier access to what of the agricultural workers and the like. Responding to the call to provide efficient, secure, and accessible government services and streamline transactions, we shall continue IDOC Bill project, varying the building national public key infrastructure, which will promote a more transparent and efficient way of documenting government activities, government web hosting service, Philippine government common platform, and the government budget, which provides standardized cybersecurity platforms for all government agencies economic development among the regions. In the ICT shall take employment opportunities in the countryside with a rural impact sourcing program. Recently, RIS has established on-road BPOs in the Pagalang Lalo del Norte. This is third class in Spanish. After one of the workshops conducted in January 2015, has launched the first ever on-road BPO in Pagalel, Samson, Oriental, again from RIS Philippines. Moreover, to provide alternatives to the BPO industry, one connect and or the UYC's initiative provides rural regions with good connectivity to narrow the regional divide. Moving forward, as described by the law, we are currently drafting the IRR for implementing rules and regulations for the in-government administration and organizational structure. Critical assessment